Hey guys, welcome to another exciting tutorial of creation process. And in this video, we'll be making this very simple but very powerful and unique design. If you see this, three alphabet has been used, ABC, but they has been formed from basic shapes like circle, rectangles. So the main body has been made from circles, and the rest part, which are used to attach as well as to form the text, has been made from a rectangle. But the one thing which we need to concentrate here is that we have to see that the thickness is constant, so we have to be very particular about the thickness, as well as there has been a rectangle which has been attached to the circle to form the letter B, and some of them has been splitted from here with the same thickness. So these are the few principles we have to understand before designing this logo. So let's begin with the design. First, to undergo with the design, we have to go in a particular step. We have to be very proportionate about that. So to be proportionate, we'll make a grid of three divisions. So first, I'll take a rectangle and draw a rectangle with some maybe almost two thickness. Give it some black color. After that, I'll just place this here. Now go to object path and split into grid. Here you can split this grid into number of divisions. Here I want 3 by 3 3 by 3, and click OK. So you got a division of 3 by 3 here. Now what I will do is I will just rotate this angle to 90 degrees. So to do that, I'll just go here, click the mouse click, and just rotate, and with a shift click you can rotate this into 90 degree angle. So I got this rectangle here. Now this grid has been made to make the outlines, to make as a guidance, to be as a guidance. So I'll just lock this up, Control 2 to lock it. And you can even, this has been the layer, so I can just use this layer to hide it and hide out, and lock this before that. Now let's go to the next step. We need the circles, so I'll just draw three circles in between the three rectangles, three circles, squares, you can see that. So we'll go to the ellipse tool, and from the center here, first just select the okay. We just need to make a new layer for that. Now with the ellipse tool, draw a circle from the center and ensure that the edges are overlapping with the edges of the boxes. So just be constant, and once you get that, increase the thickness to around the, we have to maintain its thickness, we have to be constant, so we need to see that how much thickness you are giving. So let's give it 20 thickness, or maybe you can increase to 22. Now with alt and mouse click, you can duplicate this, so place it over here. In the same way, again duplicate one more time and place it there. So once you get that, we got our three circles, we got the three positions, which is accurate. Let's convert the color into white. So before that, let's change this color into white. Now next step, we need a rectangle, piece of rectangle which will be connecting the two circles. So let's draw it. So to draw a line which will be connecting to this circles, we will use line segment tool. So from the center here, intersection part, with a shift click you can draw a line. If it's not visible, it's white, I think, yes. So where, and just a click, with a shift click you can drag it out with a 45 degree angle and just keep it there. So you got the place, correct place here. In the same way, we'll make one more here from the center intersection part, draw it out and till the intersection portion. Now we need a path here, we need a small piece here for the B. So we'll again choose the line segment tool from the intersection part or the anchor point. We'll just drag out with a shift click and straight line up here. So almost we got whole object has been prepared. Only the thing is, we have to just give some we have to cut out some strokes from here and here. So to do that, we'll just first select all of this, go to object and expand to convert this into object form. So once you get this, your object has been converted into object. We will duplicate this one more time, Control C, Control F, and change its color to black so that we can recognize it. So to do that, I'll just go here, cancel, go here and change its color to black. And arrange this to the front, arrange to front, and place it where we want our cut. I think we need our cut here, so just place it properly. Ensure that they are correctly fitted. So close, zoom in and work it out. In the same way, duplicate this one more time and place it here. We need our cut here too. Once you have done that, duplicate it one more time, place it here. And place it here. Not here, only this much. So just ensure that it's correctly placed. So just zoom in and place it properly. So now, let's do one more thing. There is one step, we have to select everything and deselect the black pieces and go to object and go to Windows Pathfinder and combine it. So in this way you got everything combined. This is one object and these all pieces are different. So select this object, select this whole object and subtract it. Now bring this small pieces again in the front before selecting. Now select this object and this and subtract it. The same way, select this and subtract it. So you got all the divisions cutted which you wanted, but only one thing is missing. You got to form the C, you have to cut this space, and we haven't done that. So to do that we'll just make the line segment, take one more, and from the center just with an angle and give it some color. Maybe you can increase it or maybe just keep it there. Again, one more from the anchor with the shift angle, you can drag out with a 45 degree angle. Now select this object, before that just ensure that the grid layer has been switched off. Sometimes it's affect the grid also. So select the path stroke, go to object path and divide object below. This will divide the object which is below there. In the same way, we'll select this, go to object path and divide object below. So this piece has been removed. So we got our ABC same, and the thing which we are left is only with the small text. So we'll just type extra, extra, extra. I think I have already given the space between the two text, so you can change that by going into the character option here. Here is the space between the two text, so you can change it here. I have given 5270, so that's why it's very small, but you can see that. Now change its color to white. You can change it from here or maybe going to the text or over there. So let's change it to white and place it properly. So this is how you can make some very unique and powerful design with in the same way. We can also say that this kind of design look very simple, but while preparing it you can undergo some complex theory. Hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Thank you very much. And don't forget to check out the upcoming tutorials. Thank you.